Number 13, is that going to be a foul against Akinkunmi?
It is, yep. They're saying he held them on the box out.
You should take a look at the replay here as Penny.
Yeah, he's got his arm wrapped around his waist. That's a good pickup there. Good pickup, that foul call.
So Toby Akinkunmi with his first foul of the game. Jack Cruz Dumont out of the game. Luka Lizdecki, a good player you coached at Langara. He's the backup point guard wearing number 3, is now checked into the game for UBC.
Yeah, he'll bring them some energy, that's for sure.
Here he is, number 3, guarding number 3. Here's Eric Beckett, number 10. Guarded by Tristan Matthews on the baseline. Turnover, UBC basketball.
I guess he must have stepped on the end line there.
So the Birds need to push the go button now here. They are in a bit of an offensive funk here, trailing by 7, still very, very early in this game. Woods to Matthews. Lizdek. Luka Lizdek, the former Kitsilano Blue Demon, and Langara Falcon. Akinkunmi drives, guarded by Radichai. Tough, high arcing shot won't go.
And Ottawa Gigi. And Luka also plays
for Ottawa. Ottawa Gigi, yeah. You're right. He's had a journey. Look at that great basket by Penny, challenging everybody inside.
I think Coach Hansen probably going to need to take a timeout here. They're really out of sorts offensively.
It's a crossover move by Woods to Lizdek. Shot clock at 10 here. The kick out to Gazina for 3. He can hit that one, can't get it to fall. UBC can't hit anything from outside here. And David Penny once again, who's had an outstanding start to his season here at UBC. Jovan Ray as well out there now for his first action of the game, wearing 0 for Simon Fraser, the Red Leafs. Shot clock now down to 5. Penny sees the paint open up and he goes inside. He's challenged by Woods. Here's Lizdek at tempo, down the floor to Gazina.
Oh man, and then they're going to give one up at the other end.
And here comes Penny.
Timeout, Kevin, timeout. There it is. That's a killer, Howard, when you get a beautiful fast break. Blow the wide open layup and everyone expecting to go in, nobody gets back, and you give one up. That's a 4-point swing.
That's a 4-point swing, and it's a 17-6 point lead, largest in the game at 11 right now for Simon Fraser. I don't know, it's tough, right? UBC has played a lot of games. Simon Fraser really hungry. We had no way knowing how this one was going to shake out in the early moments, but
it's interesting because the way the game's being played, UBC is playing more like the nervous team. I think they, you know, sometimes when you miss wide open threes especially, and they've missed 4 of them now, it dispirits you a little bit, and you don't play as good at the other end of the floor, and you can kind of see that happening. Now offensively, they're not as confident as they were before. So probably want to get any kind of a basket, even if it's just a 2, just to sort of get that confidence up again.
We'll see what Kevin Hansen has implored his troops to do coming out of this timeout. 3:02 remaining in the quarter, an 11-point lead for the Red Leafs, who will march out for his debut in this game today. A freshman from Toronto, Ontario, Thornley Secondary, Nigel Hilton, number 23. He of the Jordan-esque number and the great hair.
And long body too, 6'8 as well.
Has a great wingspan too. Look at him as he protects the paint as well. Omar El-Chazli is in the game as well. Player out of Katy, Texas of all places. He is also a freshman. Here's James Lee Jerome underneath for UBC, bringing some physicality. Can't get it to go off the window. He had a great game against UNLV. Now on the floor for UBC, Gazina as well as Matthews, Woods, and Luka Lizdek. Jovan Rai on the sidelines right in front of the Simon Fraser bench. Pitches it back out to Demacke Langan for 3. Elliott just off the mark there. Matthews with a rebound. James Woods in the offensive cog of this team. Passes out of a double team. Gazina inside. He's going to get it to go. Big basket for Gazina.
Yeah, they needed that. Beckett tried to draw the charge, but rested a no call there.
Gazina is learning on the fly here. He played so few minutes last season. That was El-Chazli with a pass to Beckett. Hilton comes up to set a high screen. Beckett inside, they go off the window. Won't go there for Hilton.
And the ball thrown out of bounds.
Yeah, Radichai lost his balance there when he came down. He had to get rid of it, and unfortunately for him, there was no other T-Bird there.
Hey, that's Jimmy Zaborniak out on the floor. Last seen him in the last game we called, Burnaby South winning the BC Championship.
And last game I saw him was the gold medal game of the Canada Games.
Well, there you go.
We lost to Ontario. But Jimmy had a great summer for us on the under 18 provincial team.
Isn't that something? The kid is...
He's a competitive kid, man. I love him.
Yeah, and really beating back some odds here to get some high kudos from his head coach throughout the early stages of the season. Jimmy Zaborniak, pure freshman from Burnaby South, will inbound the basketball wearing number one. Also out there on the floor for the first time, Emmanuel Uladele from Niagara Falls, Ontario, Ridley College. Damaki Langan swings it for the three ball.
Yeah,
are
he stepped, out
he
of
stepped
bounds.
On the end line. Yeah, oh my God, the sideline there. Omar Al-Chazli. As we mentioned, Al-Chazli is from Katy, Texas.
Now, if I'm correct, that is Friday Night Lights, right?
Yeah, it's the same neighborhood, man. Exactly. It was the guy who Simon Fraser, assistant coach Adil Sahibzada, had a contact with down in Texas and was able to bring him up here. And it was interesting. We were talking about freshmen able to play for this team in the month of October. So you're going to see a number of them, and Steve Hansen is playing a bunch of his pure freshmen on the floor right now.
And they might not play again. Right?
They may
not. They could even end up redshirting, right? You never know.
Oh, and many of them will, I think. A nice dish underneath. Simon Fraser, UBC's got to get something going. There's Sukhman Sandhu. Fouled at the three by Hilton.
Yeah, as a coach, you just hate that. There's 3 seconds from the shot clock. Sukhman's shooting a very tough shot. And he ran by him, and he hit him pretty good. You'll see here on the replay, he got him right on the arm. You're
putting an 85% free throw shooter on the line in the preseason, 28-33. So Sandhu's been doing a good job from 15. Of course,
I got to apologize
to the basketball gods above. You want to give a guy plaudits, but that's not the time to do it. Clearly, 17-8 the score here. Holy mackerel, I didn't know what I was doing. I've summoned here.
You better not go for the hat trick.
Sandhu has been so quality from the stripe. UBC can use every point they can get here as he measures that one up to go 1 of 3. It's a raining and it pours situation here in the first quarter for UBC. They're trailing by 8. Still a lot of time left here as Damaki Langan with the basketball.
Wow.
Oh, what a shot.
That was a beautiful, that had the crowd ooing and awing as he made his defender fall down. There was only a 2, though. His foot was on the line. But that was a nice move.
Puts it out to double digits again for Simon Fraser, 19-9. Here's Sandhu at the high post. The quick pass to Woods. Woods has double team attention. Zaborniak guarding him. Woods posting up. Inside, the sweeping hook doesn't go. Jamesley Jerome will swipe at the ball.
Well, I mean, that's a good matchup for UBC. Obviously, Woods against Zaborniak, but as I said, Zaborniak's a competitive kid, and he didn't give anything up there.
Jimmy Zaborniak wearing number one. A lot of freshmen out there right now for Simon Fraser. Hilton, Odelele, Zaborniak, Al-Chazli, and Elliot Damaki Langan. A second-year guy is the veteran, and hits Elliot Damaki Langan with a basketball right now. Morense guarding him. Damaki Langan shakes and finds Hilton at the top for 3. Here's the 3-ball. Hilton doesn't go for him. Ball pinballs right into the hands of Simon Fraser. And that's Emmanuel Oladele.
Good defense there by Woods. Forced the turnover. UBC's going to have 11 seconds, 10.9 seconds here to get a shot off.
And they need to take any kind of momentum they can into the second quarter. There's Lizdek picking it up, 10 seconds to go. Sukhman with a quick catch and shoot. 3 is gonna go, Sukhman Sandhu.
Oh, he got a steal, oh.
Here's Zaborniak, puts it up, can't get it to go, but a big basket by Sukhman, they needed that.
And what they did there was they actually, Woods came off of Sukhman on a little curl screen, and when he curled hard, Sukhman's man sagged a little bit and they gave him that opening 3, and that's their first 3 of the quarter. So, that'll maybe give them some momentum. I mean, UBC is such a strong offensive team, and they're known for that. They only put up a dozen in that quarter.
Isn't that something? UBC Their cumulative scores have been 86 to 67. That's been the average score that they've won by to go 6-6-0. But the good job there defensively, obviously, by Simon Fraser. Hey, Simon Fraser looks like, have they found the cheat code here, Eve? They've got three guys that had substantial minutes, and they brought in a whole bunch of guys, and they look like they're going to be okay. Like, I mean, they picked them ninth in the GNAC, and Coach Hansen thought,
that.
Hey, I don't agree with that.
But you know what? I guarantee you Coach Hansen is more than happy with that. Because that's those coaches, we always sandbag, and we love it when people underrate us, right? Because then you get you guys motivated. So they have good length, and it's interesting because they have a lot of dudes, right? They got a lot, and so they're competing hard for minutes, right? So it's going to be very interesting, right, to see what ends up happening, because some of these guys, like you said, that we're seeing tonight, they might not even end up playing on the roster.
Yeah, they might not. And I was actually surprised that he had that many freshmen play. He had four pure freshmen on the floor at one time.
He did, yeah.
So very, very talented blue chip recruiting class by head coach Steve Hansen here with the Simon Fraser Red Leafs. And now it's up to the UBC Thunderbirds to protect home court. Can they turn the tide here in the second quarter? The starting group looks like they're coming out here with the exception of Tobiak and Kubney, number 13.
Interesting, too, that, you know, the way the game's played nowadays, you know, so much spacing, so many threes, this has not been like that. Like, it's been a lot of, you know, tough defense, trying to get inside. You know, it hasn't been that wide open, which personally I think plays to SFU. SFU wants that kind of game.
Taking us back to the 90s, man. I love this. We old guys, you know. 19-12 as Jamal Wright will inbound right in front of our broadcast location here to start the second quarter. He's out there with Tamaki Langan. And Simon Fraser keeping some of their other players on the floor. Oladele, one of them, number five. Here's Zaborniak guarded by Cruz Dumont. Jimmy Z under pressure. And he's going to get it stolen away by Woods.
Yeah, tough possession there. They hounded him like crazy.
UBC went 1-for-5 from three in that opening quarter. Tough struggle, but a big basket there by Woods. And a bit of a comeback here by UBC. There's a high arcing three put up there by Oladele. And it's not going to go. Oladele, I should say. Here's Woods working off the Sandus. Look at the spin move by Woods in traffic. Almost gets it. Tough to want to go. Just held shy at the rim. Zaborniak. Jamal Wright. Demacki Langan. Wright gets it back. This time it's Zaborniak. Is he going to turn a corner? No, he'll body his way. Fading shot. Tough one. Jimmy Z.
He likes that little pull-up. Alec Chris Paul.
Right down the floor, though, comes UBC.
Yes, if you fell asleep there, Coach Hansen not happy.
Brian Wallach bounding down the floor. The 21-16, UBC's cut it to 5 points. I think the largest lead was 12 or 11 in that opening quarter. Here's Zaborniak, the no-look dish for three. Jamal Wright off the side of the goal.
I think we're going to have a foul, yeah, off the ball there, right. Was it right? Someone gave a two-hand push.
I didn't hear who the foul was against.
Yeah, I didn't catch that one either. Huh?
Oh, did they say it was, is it Lefebvre getting the foul again? He's heading off the
floor. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, that's
my gosh.
Was on. That's who it was on.
Well, that's an interesting turn of events because Lefebvre is one of those guys you count on. One of those.
That's three fouls?
Three, yeah. Quick ones. Boy, and he is, I'm going to see him to the second half. Underneath, UBC working hard, getting physical underneath, and the whistle blowing, Tobiak and Kumney working hard.
I thought Toby got away with a little travel there. But he went strong and got the foul.
Simon Fraser returning to a more veteran group on the floor here. With Penny Demacki Langan, Radichai, and Jamal Wright, along with the freshman Oladele, wearing number five. Emmanuel Oladele, 66205 on the Niagara Falls. Here's Demacki Langan from beyond the arc. Too strong off the back iron. Ball tipped, chased down by Penny. And they got a call over and back on David Penny.
And Penny looked like he got hit in his calf there. I think he's okay.
Well, UBC started to storm back a bit late in that opening quarter. They've kept it going here in the second. They've got the basketball in the front court. Tristan Matthews will inbounds to Cruz Dumont. Here's Jack in the lane, spinning off the window. Can't find the touch underneath, and Akin Kubni battling as well underneath. Oladele, the drive, the kick. Radichai for three. Victor Radichai.
Two for two for three. Two for two.
He is going to be fun to watch in the Simon Fraser West Gym this season, in the GNAT for sure. Here's Woods. Came in averaging over 20 a game. Matthews, Tristan. Cruz Dumont baseline. Jack's going to knock down the little baseline jumper. To a two-possession game here. Here's Penny weaving into the paint. Ball skips out of his hands. James Woods quickly down the floor to Cruz Dumont. The touch pass down! And Wallach will lay it down with great authority.
Wallach made no mistake about that lob that time.
Jack Cruz Dumont laid that one up, and Wallach put it down, and the Thunderbird faithful explode here, 24-21. Simon Fraser with a basketball and a much slimmer lead here in the second quarter. Demacki Langan underneath. Shot clock's at one. Wright's got to put it up.
No shot.
Jamal Wright didn't know what the shot clock was at, unfortunately, for Simon Fraser. So UBC finding some momentum here. What's been key for UBC in their comeback here?
Well, I mean, I think they forced two turnovers, maybe three, right to start right away. And two of their baskets came off that, including that spectacular dunk. So they're doing it with the defense and then creating easier shots. SFU's got to take better care of the ball, as it looks like Jimmy Z's coming back in for Penny.
So we'll see how those adjustments go. Jimmy Z getting some quality time here at such a key position on the floor. And that tough fading shot he hit in the half court, impressive for a pure freshman to come in and stick here at War Gym. So good to see number one playing well for the ex-Burnaby South Rebel. They go in the post to Gazina. The jump hook is going to go for the kid from King George Secondary.
Nice little high-low action there, with Gazina sealed and got the pass from the high post.
Nikolai Gazina, 24-23, Simon Fraser with a one-point lead. For the basketball purists, the game we came to see. Here's Jovan Rye on the baseline. Into a double team quickly. Oh, Beckett goes right into the paint. Matthews took the brunt of that hit, but no worse for wear, number eight. But gets called for the blocking foul.
That was 230 pounds going up against 220 pounds on that collision.
There you go.
Two pretty big guys.
Oh, anyone who says basketball isn't a physical sport, just look at those.
Now, interesting here that UBC has crept right back into this. James Woods, 0 points.
Isn't that funny? Simon Fraser puts it out to 25-23, the two-point lead. And getting challenged and entertained on every possession here down the court. Here's Wallach, Beckett right in his face, enters, tough pass down to Gazina. And the young man down in the post almost was able to score, showing some nice touch in low, just couldn't get it to go. Simon Fraser now facing the best of UBC here on their home court at Historic War Gym. Here's Zaborniak. Jimmy Z stutter steps all over the court. Skips it out. Beckett, 15-footer goes. So the kid from Vermont with a football body shows some nice touch there. Cruz Dumont can't shake Zaborniak back up top. Gazina, the fake, the hip check from Radichai. It's gonna go. And how about Gazina?
Now we'll see if they call that on Radichai or if they call that on Beckett.
Now, So on Radichai. Yep. So he's got
so
three.
He's got three now, too.
Lefebvre and Radichai, the two starting bigs, have three fouls each 5 minutes from the half. Kuzina around the basketball. Nice hustle there from Jamal Wright. He couldn't reel that one in.
And another missed free throw, but UBC got the ball back on the rebound. Referees right now just trying to figure out where the shot clock should be.
Well, this one is going to be a knockdown, drag-out brawl. It's not going to be a high-scoring basketball game the way these two teams are playing.
And Coach Hans is going to take his first time out of the half.
And great factoid, Ebe, on Woods. I mean, they are keeping him down, right?
They really are. They're guarding him hard. And, you know, but it's a positive sign for UBC that they still found a way to get back in the game and only be down two now. That is a, let me see, that's a, it was nine. That's a 16-8 run for UBC right now.
So UBC
from
feeling.
The end, from the time that Shookman hit that three.
Gotcha. That's a big turnaround. It's clearly right near the end of that opening quarter. And SFU got out to a great start here. Nice crowd here at War Gym here to see this game. And, of course, UBC will open Canada West play against UNBC. Still a few weeks down the road. But they're going to be ready.
So you can see they're just showing the huddle for SFU. I don't know if the camera picked it up, but Coach Hansen's coaching board is ridiculous. It is way too big. Like, if I had that coaching board, I couldn't even reach to draw. No, it's ridiculous. It's like the I think one of his managers, that's his only job, to carry it. I've never seen. Look at it. See, you see it?
Oh, my gosh. That thing's huge.
I couldn't. Yeah, my arms would be too short to draw on that one.
Wow, isn't that something?
See the important stuff I notice, Howard?
Hey, I love it that you bring out the comical. That is hilarious. Goodness. I missed it. I was staring at the coaching board.
Right off the inbound, they found Victor, and he got hammered by number 21, Stone, and so he'll get two free throws.
Zach Stone, number 21.
Oh, sorry, it was Wallach that got fouled. Wallach.
So Wallach will go to the free throw line. Stone's first foul. He's a 6'11 player who, when Jazz Singh went out last year in January, there was a thought they would bring Zach Stone off of his redshirt and play him. They thought they needed the height. They kept him. I think they're happy they preserved the year because I think he'll develop into a big part of that front court rotation for them. Brings some nice size. Wallach can tie the game right here. He will do that as UBC continues the rally. Zaborniak to Beckett. Kuzina out in the perimeter guarding him. Beckett, nice scoop underneath to Wright, and he's going to get fouled by Matthews underneath the basket.
Yeah, Wright made a great backdoor cut. And a super find by Beckett.
He was part of that starting group last year, Ebe, and played a lot of minutes. Only averaged 6.6 points a game, but he had the three guys playing in front of him, and Will Bellata and all their top players last year. So he's been really, Coach Hansen saying he expects him to play at a league all-star level. I think a lot of responsibility falling on number 15, the only returning front court player that saw any significant minutes at all in the SFU roster. He is a former Division I player at Maryland Eastern Shore. Luka Lizdek, guarded by Zaborniak. Out to James Woods. Here's Gazina. Boy, I'm impressed with Gazina off the window.
Yeah, just a little too much athleticism there for Stone to be able to guard him.
Those strides were massive when he turned the corner. Gazina covered some real estate there. Here's Wright at the other end for Simon Fraser. Game locked at 29-4-12 from the break. What a dandy we've got here at War Gym. Jovan Rye, and Cruz Dumont's going to get called for the foul as he guards Jovan Rye on the perimeter.
SFU's setting a lot of high ball screens, and UBC's being super aggressive on them. They're jump switching it. They're trapping it. They're really attacking these screens. SFU should look to either back dribble and reverse the ball, or we saw earlier when Jimmy Z made that split between them, because they're getting pushed out too far.
Great point. We'll see how chess works here. The chess match continues as Coach Kevin Hansen has clearly lit a fire under his troops here heading into the second quarter. Zaborniak right for three. Jamal's shot is going to swish through the net. So 32-29, Simon Fraser needed that one. The Red Leafs with a three-point lead. Cruz Dumont to Gazina. Boy, Nikola Gazina's looking more confident every time down the floor. Gazina's wingspan, I mean, he's a tall kiddie, but I think his wingspan outstrips his height. It is impressive. Right. Here's Lizdek. Luka explodes, tries to get past Zaborniak, cross court. Cruz Dumont for three! And Cruz Dumont took a hit there from Penny, but he got it to go, no foul call.
Tough shot.
32-32, big shot by Jack. The former Vancouver College product. Zaborniak into the paint to kick back out. Beckett, Eric Beckett. He's gonna pull up from about 18 and he's gonna get, almost got the roll there. Underneath right, trying to squeeze it, couldn't. I think that's gonna be a UBC basketball.
No, it looks like, I thought it was too. I think they're giving it to SFU.
Oh, okay, Simon Fraser basketball then.
It looked like it was off right, but
must have tipped off of, a UBC player there. So Zaborniak will inbound. 14 on the shot clock, 3:11 to the break. Here's Penny. Cruz Dumont guarding him in the corner. Penny's got a great handle. He'll reset with 7 on the shot clock. Hilton coming up high. UBC doing a great job, but right to the window.
Yeah, that's what we were talking about, right? He split the screen, and there was no help defense once he did that.
Wow. So Penny, the benefactor, hanging tough as the shot clock goes down, and UBC unable to stop him as he cuts a path for the basket. 34-32 for the visitors. Into the paint, Woods the skip underneath, can't get it to go to Wallach. Here's Penny again. Command force, all preseason GNAC at point guard, swings it across. Oh, almost goes there. A tough break there, and a nice play by the rookie from Katy, Texas, Omar El Chasley.
I think Woods is actually being a little too unselfish. I'd like to see him take that shot. He's trying to work through this tough defense, but I'd like to see him be a bit more selfish sometimes. That was a tough pass. He probably should have taken that out.
Well, Woods will stay out there while UBC makes some changes on the floor.
Looks like Sukman's back in.
Sukman Sandu, indeed, number 16, back into the game, as is Eze Morense, wearing 0. El Chasley makes the first free throw. Coach Hansen is going to have some tough decisions to make on who he redshirts this season. The pure freshmen have come in and really held their own. He's going to miss the sack. Wallach ripping down the rebound. 2:23 to the break. A one possession lead here for Simon Fraser. UBC with the basketball. Luka Lizdek.
There's Wallach. The high-low.
Sukman. And he had the rookie Hilton underneath, and Sukman Sandu able to score it. That's the veteran at work. UBC trailing by 1. Simon Fraser with the basketball to Mackie Langan. Morense guarding him. The skip underneath it goes. Hilton.
Coach Hansen wanted to travel on that one.
Well, he got it
Coach
to go.
Coach Kevin Hansen.
Yeah, I was going to say, we almost have to say Coach Steve or Coach Kevin here.
That was a solid shot from Mr. Matthias Van Bylen. He's getting in the game. Watch this right here. Watch this right here. He just hammers him. Boom.
Matthias Van Bylen, of course, the freshman from Hansworth Secondary in North Vancouver. Both he and Tate Christensen, the two freshmen from the famed North Vancouver program that made the Simon Fraser varsity here. We'll see as Wallach hits the second free throw. If the Hansworth pair actually play this year or are redshirted, we get a chance to see them in action here today. Three ball doesn't go there by El Chasley. Simon Fraser still with it. Van Bylen, they reset with a shot to Hilton. And a couple minutes here by Simon Fraser. UBC with a chance to take the lead with 1:21 left here in the opening half. James Woods. Van Bylen pumped to be guarding Woods here. Hilton as well. Woods will swing it cross court to Lizdek. Luka into the paint. Oh, and he gets a tough basket. That's a playground hoop there for Luka Lizdek.
And UBC has the lead for the first time.
38-37, Birds with 1 minute left. They complete the comeback from double digits down, and they are currently leading this game. Here's Demacke Langan. He's going to put up his own three. That one is not going to fall. Nice box out by Woods, and he's going to take it all the way. The full 94, and James Woods will lay it up and in.
And he's got on the board with a rebound and a fast break push.
Great job by 11. Those are the first 2 points of the game, as he pointed out, for Woods. Here's Penny from 15.
And UBC can hold for the last shot here.
I think Simon Fraser has a 1 point lead, do they not? They should, they just scored the last basket. Not sure if that score clock is correct, but we'll see. Woods with 6 seconds into the paint, can't get it to go. Demacke Langan, his eyes on the 1 second from half court, and it's not gonna go. 40-39. Here's the score. I thought
UBC went up one on the Woods layup, and then Lizdek got another layup.
Oh, of course.
And then they went up three. So
there
that is right. Yeah.
As long as we got the correct score,
that's
good. 40-39 is the score at the half. UBC with the lead. And Ebe, you know what? We saw both teams put runs on each other in this game, but for the most part, hard-nosed basketball, it means so much. And I know even the American guys that's on Simon Fraser, I think, picked up pretty quickly on how big this game was.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, there's no question. You just the environment electric here, right? And interesting, too, that UBC scored only 9 points after 9 minutes and 50 seconds. Sukman hits that three, and they've gone to score 28 since then. So they more than doubled what they scored in that first nine minutes and 50 seconds.
Exactly. Well, they found some kind of a magic formula to get back into this basketball game, and now all bets are off. 40-39, a one-point game at the half. UBC with the lead over the Simon Fraser Red Leafs in the 36th annual Buchanan Cup here from Historic War Gym. For Paul Eberhard, Howard Summer, we'll take a halftime break here and be back with the stats and the second half in a few minutes.
Let's give it up one more time for your UBC Thunderbirds! Thunderbird fans. How's everybody doing tonight? Oh, I know you guys can give me more than that. One more time. How's everybody doing tonight? That's what I'm talking about, everybody. We got the fan favorite competition coming up here. It is time for the half court shot contest. That's right, we have four lucky fans. Each of them has one shot to make a half court shot on that hoop. Do you think they can do it, everybody? That's what I'm talking about. All right, our first competitor will grab basketball for her, and then we'll bring her to half court. Give it up for Erica, everybody. All right, Erica, how you feeling? Are you ready? Fans, let's make some noise for Erica. We'll be shooting on this hoop here.
It's kind of hard to see from the house with that thing, yeah. It would be good.
All right, Erica, whenever you are ready. It's a good shot. It's a little bit short. Let's give her a big round of applause, everybody. All right, our second competitor up. Let me hear you make some noise for two. There's the shot. It's a good one. Just a little bit short. Give you a big round of applause. All right, our third contestant. Let me hear you hop it up for Olivia. One yet, and our fourth contestant. Let's give it up one more time for Olivia, everybody. Our fourth and final contestant. Let me dance together for Nathan. Wow, way over the top. What do we think? Fans, what do you think? Should we each give them one more shot? One more shot, everybody. Go. A big prize in that store for whoever makes it. Now I'm just a little short. Chuku's gonna be stepping back up. Give it up one more time for Chuku. All right, just two contestants. These contestants are playing for a one-night stay at the Western Bayshore, so a pretty big grand prize. Give it up for Olivia! Off the backboard, off the side. All right, our final shot is half-court. Man, we need the energy up in here. It's the last one. Let's get it going for Nathan, everybody! Stop the stop. Let's give them all a big round of applause. A big thank you to our contestants for playing. Stay loud, stay proud, viewers. Give it up for your UBC cheer team!
Yeah. return to the gym. Give it up for your UBC Thunderbirds.
And welcome back, everybody, to War Memorial Gymnasium. It's halftime, and the atmosphere is electric here at War Memorial Gymnasium on the campus of the University of British Columbia. And Ebe, it was an exciting first half. It had its ebbs and flows. We look at some of these numbers in a low-scoring game, and what are some of the numbers that kind of jump out at you?
Well, a couple of things jump out right away. First of all, UBC only taking six threes really surprised me. They're 2 for 6, but that's a very low number for what they normally take. SFU took twice as many, they were 3 for 12. But I think the number that SFU's got to be worried about is the fouls. Because UBC went the line 14 times, they only went the line 6 times. So that's a 6-point difference. And of course, you've got Lefebvre and Radichai both with 3. So I think those would be the numbers that Coach Hansen's got to be a bit worried about. UBC went the line a lot more in that second quarter. So they're going to have to try to shore that up.
UBC is leading by a point at 40-39. James Woods, though, only 2 of 7 from the field. 4 points, came in averaging 20 a game. Brian Wallach, though, made up for a lot of that with 12 points in the half. And he was 8 of 8 from the free throw line. We saw some great energy from Brian Wallach.
Well, and you know, when they went to that high-low set that we talked about, that's where they created some contact, got to the foul line, and made some baskets. So the fact that both big men for SFU were out, UBC did a smart job of going inside and taking advantage of it.
You've watched James Woods play for so many years, and you know he's going to take the first half personally. What do you expect from him in the second half, Paul?
Well, you know, I'm sure he's going to look to obviously exert himself more than he did, but he's not the kind of player that will force it. And I think for him, if they can get a bit more transition, either off defensive boards or turnovers, then I think that's more his game to get him going. I mean, that's how he got going in the first place, was with that coast-to-coast rebound. So I think he should look for more opportunities there to get him going a little bit.
Simon Fraser led by the 10 points of David Penny, 9 from Jamal Wright and Victor Radichai, despite those 3 fouls, 6 points on 2 of 2 shooting from beyond the arc. I got to ask you about David Penny. What impressed you about his generalship, his skill set, everything on the floor in that opening half?
Well, he's very steady. Like, he doesn't make a lot of mistakes, and he makes the right pass most of the time. Like, twice we saw him split that attack on the screen, and once he got a layup and once he kicked for a 3, they missed. So he's very steady. He understands the game. He might have to step up his own offensive game a bit if other guys don't start doing it, though.
Hey, I got an email from former UBC lead assistant Ross Tomlinson, who coached under Bruiser, Bruce Enns, and Ross for coach was asking, hey, Coach Enns would love to watch the game, and we, you know, can we get the link? And so Bruce Enns is watching tonight. Let's have a shout out to Bruce Enns, who's meant so much to this program.
Of course, my brother played for the Bruisers first year here. Doug played from the point guard spot, and I was a student here at that time too. many a day that I go into his office to talk hoops because I was a young guy coaching McGee at that time.
Oh, yeah.
And I really enjoyed that relationship. Yeah, it's awesome. Nice to hear you watching us, Bruiser.
And, yeah, definitely, Bruce. It's Howard Hayes.
Down in Bremerton, I believe.
Down in Bremerton, Washington. Yeah. One of the all-time greats. Bruce Enns coached so many wonderful moments here, including the great J.D. Jackson here in War Memorial Gymnasium. As we start the second half, it's UBC with the basketball, and that's Jack Cruz Dumont. Skipping to Sandu down low, and it's going to go off the big man's hands and out of bounds.
Yeah, a little bit too low for Sandu to get that. Not a great pass from Cruz Dumont there.
The big man having to really show some bend in the large frame there. Turned over, and now it's Penny, who we just talked about. Coach Ebe talking about his great skill set, number three on the floor, the floor general for Simon Fraser's going to pull up for three, just off the front iron of the hands of Woods. James Woods, we mentioned, 2 of 4 in that opening half. And he'd love to get his team on a roll. That's a deep three, and he's going to knock it down. James Woods.
He got the switch off of the screen, and he took advantage of it with a step back. As you said, very deep three.
Deep, deep three. And Coach Kevin Hansen mentioned, you know, as he watches NBA games, how deep they're shooting threes. James Woods, the guy that likes to shoot from the deep parts of the court as well. Jamal Wright couldn't get it. Woods now with the basketball. He's got Lefebvre on the run as he goes down the court. Ooh, and coming from behind, I think Beckett, number 10, the transfer guard, able to knock it out of bounds.
Yeah, great hustle back to get that block. As you see right here on the replay.
Our thanks to Shoyel Brown for giving us the laptop computer courtside. Our view of the big screen here obscured by the basket at one end of the court, so we got a much better view of the replays here in the second half. Here's Sandu, little jump hook, rolls off the iron into the hands of Beckett. Quickly up the floor, feeding Penny. David behind the back, battling Cruz Dumont. And number 10 is going to be whistled for a foul there. And credit David Penny for the great ball control at tempo coming down the floor.
Yeah, and a smart play. He wasn't ever going to make that basket, but he made sure that he leaned in to get the contact to get to the foul line.
Savvy play from number 3, David Penny. Came in averaging, or last season rather, played a workman like 33 minutes a game last season. Third in the GNAC in assists. Shot 30% from three in the GNAC last year. Averaged 10.3 points and 4.8 assists. Goal this year to lead the GNAC in assists. And that's no small feat. Here is Penny makes good from the free throw line. Woods working off the high screen instead, now battling Lefebvre. That ball pinballs into the hands of Wright, who shows some great hops down low to go get that one. Damaki Langan quickly to Penny on the far sideline. Lizdek guarding him. UBC in a bit of a zone look. Underneath they go, and a great job there by Beckett on the baseline.
Yeah, they just got burned on that back door cut. Matthews was not prepared for it. Turned his head and got blown by in the back door cut.
So there's Beckett, number 10, showing some dexterity despite the thick frame he brings. Couple minutes in here, the second half underway, and of course we know this broadcast going out everywhere in the streaming world. And if you are settling in for a night of basketball, thanks for choosing us here at War Gym. Another deep three, this time too strong.
That was a Curry deep there.
Too strong off the back iron there by Woods. Penny back now to Beckett, who lowers a shoulder on Wallach.
Great defense by Wallach.
And there goes Woods. Can't get that one to go, but a foul called. And Woods is going to get to the free throw line.
Brian Wallach. Nice push here in transition. What we talked about, he got right by him and took the bump.
So Woods is heating up here, and I love the fact that Wallach dedicated so much energy to improving his physical stature coming out of Semiahmoo Secondary, and really, he is going to absorb a lot of contact in there this year. His mobility, his increased scoring touch, everything. Brian Wallach stepping up big here for UBC, wearing number 7 in the front court.
Yeah, as you said, he has put a ton of time into getting bigger and stronger and working in the weight room. Very impressive. And there he gets aboard.
It's aboard. Sookman for three. Off the mark. Can't get it to go. Beckett chases down the loose ball. So let's lock this one up at 43. Strap yourselves in for a great second half here as Penny in the half court. That wide wingspan of Sukman Sandhu cutting off all the lanes here. Penny keeps probing. Shot clock now down to 7 for the point guard. Into the paint, makes a tough one go. David Penny with a big basket there. Simon Fraser, 45-43. Here is Wallach at the high post, puts it on the deck. Ooh, right into the hands of Penny as he was looking for Tristan Matthews. Simon Fraser looking to build on the two-point lead. Lizdek instead will take the loose ball. 2-on-1 with Lefebvre to Wallach at the other end of the court. That one looked like it might fail for a moment, but Wallach able to pull it out of the fire.
Yeah, Wallach composed himself, gave it a little pump fake, got under control. Nice finish there.
You bet. EB locks it up here at 45. Neither team can get on a big run here as George Lefebvre to Beckett. That's Vermont to Vermont. To Beckett, tough fading shot's going to swish it.
You called that. That was a tough, tough shot. Showing some deft touch there. Wow.
47-45, Simon Fraser. Boy, this is such a ridiculously different roster from last season, but Coach Steve Hansen has his guys dialed in here. Here's Tristan Matthews, little crossover on Lefebvre, puts up a jump shot, contested. Damaki Langan went up for that rebound and, ooh, goes down hard as he just fell over Sandhu. Yeah. Sukman Sandhu looked like he had position there, established, I thought that. It's his first foul of the game. On the floor now, Emmanuel Oladele, number 5. Another freshman, Victor Radichai, number 35. Out there with Damaki Langan, right, and with the ball, David Penny. Here's Damaki Langan back up top. Radichai, one bounce, a skip to Oladele in the paint. And he's going to score it. He gets in behind Sukman Sandhu for the lay-in.
Clearly, Coach Steve Hansen talked to his team about looking to go backdoor and exploit the aggressiveness of UBC's defense, because that's their third basket on a backdoor this half.
We'll see if UBC makes that adjustment next time down the floor defensively. Instead, right now, they try and get those two back. With Sandhu, Radichai right in his face. Great D there by Radichai. Underneath.
Beautiful out-of-bounds save there by Cruz Dumont.
And Guzina able to finish
it. Yeah, he jumped out of bounds and saved it right to Guzina. Nice hustle there.
Two Vancouver High School products combining there for the UBC basket. Here's Radichai, guarded by Sandhu, finds right. Jamal, wild shot, Sukman Sandhu there to change the direction of that one. Cruz Dumont now, under 5 minutes remaining in a fast-moving third quarter. Here's Woods, finds Gazina, Nicola, jump shot, doesn't go against Radichai. Radichai making his defensive presence felt. Here's Penny, he's going to pull up from 15. Quick outlet for UBC. Cruz Dumont now to Woods underneath. James, the reverse move underneath the basket, can't find the English. So each team being stymied at the other end of the floor, neither can get on a run here and keep it at a two-point lead for Simon Fraser. Oladele, three ball, high arcing shot. Oladele showing us something.
And that was really well defended. That was just a tough, tough shot to hit.
That is a freshman, Emmanuel Oladele, 6'6", 205, a swingman out of Niagara Falls and Ridley College. Here's Lizdek, wide open on the baseline for Luka. UBC needed those points. They pulled it within a possession. It's the 36th Buchanan Cup, and looks like these two schools are making a solid commitment to making this an annual event. Here's Oladele into the paint, the big strides, gets the roll. Number 5 is inspiring off the bench for the guys in red. The Red Leafs now with the lead of 5 points.
I think Sandhu needs a sub. He's breathing really hard right now.
Number 16 feeling it. Here's Kuzina. Ooh, and that foul is going to go against Elliot Tamakulang and number 20 of Simon Fraser.
Believe it or not, Howard, they didn't call that.
Oh.
It was a foul, but they called out of bounds, and they're actually giving it to Simon Fraser.
Wow, that's a tough break.
Yeah, very tough. You had a lot of contact there.
3:14 here left in the third quarter. That's going to be Jamal Wright inbounding the ball. Jimmy Zaborniak, the pure freshman out of Burnaby South, now on the floor wearing jersey number one for the Red Leafs. James Lee Jerome and Luka Lizdek out there along with Kazina Matthews. And as well, Akin Kudney, number 13 for UBC. Here's Zaborniak for three. Jimmy Z just off the mark there. Jerome with a rebound. Luka Lizdek to Tristan Matthews. Matthews, a dead-eye shooter, just hasn't been able to get the shot off the way he wants tonight. Certainly a dead-eye talent there shooting the basketball. Great job jumping it by Jimmy Z down the floor, and Jimmy Z all over the place.
And Coach Hansen's going to take a timeout as now we got a little 7-0 run here from the Red Leafs.
And Odelele and Zaborniak, two pure freshmen.
Giving them a nice punch off the bench, aren't they?
Boy, we said Steve Hansen was going to have some tough decisions to make on who not to redshirt on this roster, and certainly that looks like the case. Some real inspired play by Jimmy Zaborniak. Hey, just tell us, I mean, about Jimmy's summer.
He had a great summer. He was our starting point guard for most of the summer.
This is the under 18.
This is the under 18 provincial team. We competed in Niagara at the Canada Games. We went in as like the 7th ranked team, and we just played great. Made it all the way to the gold medal final where we were tied at halftime with Ontario. It's funny, our kids, Jimmy and them, a lot of the Ontario had like, you know, four under 18 national team players. Alberta had somebody, and we didn't have anybody, so we called ourselves the No Leafs. Because there's this rating system that they do online for, you know, how many Leafs you get. And so they had all these four Leaf guys. And so we called ourselves the BC No Leafs. It was a little nickname
precious.
They came up with, that the boys came up with. So, but yeah, he knows how to win. And it's so hard to teach that, right? That gold medal game that we lost was literally the first time he hasn't won. Because they won junior and they won senior, right? You know?
You're right about that. Shout out to head coach Mike Bell, who does such a great job on that Burnaby South team.
That's not what you want out of a timeout. Another turnover for the T-Birds.
So Burnaby South with a chance to imprint a very similar schematic that they opened the game with in the first quarter when they jumped out to an 11-point lead. Right now, leading by 7 with 2:23 remaining.
UBC's gone to his own here.
Tamaki Langan wants to melt it by shooting right over the top. Jovan Rye with a rebound there.
And I wonder if they're in the penalty yet. No, that's the fourth foul.
Toby Akinkumni with the foul, his second of the game. Simon Fraser finding the momentum again. Jovan Rye. Jamal right to handoff. Tamaki Langan. Elliott crossover move gets him into the paint to skip over. Here's Jimmy Z for three, and he just goes off the iron wide. UBC with a chance here to press the go button here as Lizdek quickly down the floor. Matthews shot fake into the paint. Tristan can't get that one to go. Gazina working hard, but Jovan Rye is going to come up with a basketball. Jovan Rye, who Steve Hansen said might be the most improved guy from last season to this season among the returning guys.
And you know, he did it was a real subtle thing, but just outside the three-point line, did like a little inside-out dribble, got the defense to turn, and then he one dribble to the hoop and drew the foul. You see that right there? It's a simple move, and he created that contact.
So Jovan Rye, what a job he's doing here at Markham, Ontario. 6'4", 186 in his sophomore year. Not able to sink that first free throw.
And as you can see, SFU getting the line this quarter. UBC has not, SFU's only committed one foul this quarter, so they cleaned up that part of it.
Rye's going to miss both of them, but he wants to make up for it. Runs hard, tries to chase it down. Right in front of our broadcast location here, floor level, at War Gym. It's going to remain SFU's basketball.
right now, all of the kind of 50-50 balls are going SFU's way.
Well, Wallach and Sandu are now back into the game, and this is key for UBC, but I think they got to pull all of the stops, and if they're going to win here in front of their home crowd, they're going to have to get something done quickly here.
And there you go, just like that, steal.
Woods down the floor. A little out of control there as Wallach tries to tightrope the baseline.
Looks like Zaborniak got a little push there, so UBC will keep the ball.
Jimmy Zaborniak with his first foul of the game. Liz Deck will inbound with 21 on the shot clock, 1:30 left here in this third quarter of play. Buchanan Cup bringing out all the basketball emotions in our British Columbia basketball community, and thanks to all the coaches and players and fans watching if they're not in the gym tonight. Tristan Matthews, great look down low. They'll skip it. Woods now. Boy, Wallach had an opportunity.
Yeah, I don't know why he passed that out.
Sukman to Woods. Woods is going to just knock down the triple. James Woods doing what he does best.
Yeah, so a bit of a scramble play there, but UBC will definitely take it.
And they lean on their biggest scoring talent thus far this season, game number 7 for UBC. And Woods knocks down the triple, makes it a 4-point game with a minute left. Jovan Rye pivoting with a jump hook, can't get it to go. Here's Woods again. Woods attacking. And this Odelele as Woods comes boundings right into our broadcast location. You can see the potential of a freshman player like Odelele, number 5. He's going to be something in the GNAC.
Absolutely. Played at Ridley College back in Ontario.
I hear it's the St. George's of Toronto. Is that basically what it is?
Yeah. That's a pretty good description.
Yeah.
Very good basketball program.
Here's Penny. Back up top now to Beckett. Finding Odelele. Beckett.
You know, I had a perfect look at that. I don't think he touched the line. What do you think?
I don't know. I just looked at him.
I was looking right there. Yeah. And I'm like, because his heel was up. I don't think his heel went down.
Well, they made the call there, and UBC's got to take advantage here with 21.1 seconds. They get the basketball back off the turnover.
Let's see what they're going to run here. High screen and roll.
4.4 seconds. Woods jump stop reverse in the... Oh, and Wallach almost tipped it in. It's not going to go.
Yeah, Wallach had a good chance at a tip there and just didn't quite get it.
So after three quarters of play, 56-52 is our score. Simon Fraser with the lead. The Red Leafs a 4-point advantage here. A fourth quarter coming up that UBC needs to muster and find something if they want to win in front of their home crowd.
Yeah, they didn't quite get... sort of enough of an offensive flow once again, kind of like we saw in the first quarter. Although going to their zone there, the SFU had a tough time against that zone. We'll see if Kevin stays in that, because they didn't really get any good shots against it, but they weren't able to take advantage of it at the other end.
So Simon Fraser last year came away with the victory. We referenced it off the top. It was a very, very exciting game. And that Simon Fraser team was filled with veterans. But this Simon Fraser team has been absolutely impressive here tonight. The amount of time they've had to get their act together. They played Victoria in a control. They called it a scrimmage. I don't know if they just, whatever it was. I mean, reports of the game are getting out to everybody. And some people have seen all the stats and stuff. But SFU apparently got out to a big lead on Victoria. Victoria came back. Diego Mafia, what a great player, right? What a great team. Coach Bocamp runs there. At Victoria, they were able to come away and win that game. So that's pretty interesting as a measure, right?
It is, because, I mean, we know Victoria is going to be very good again. They had one of their best seasons in a long time last year, and, you know, they got a lot of guys back. They're going to be at the top of the Canada West along with UBC. Of course, UBC's played Calgary in a very close game that they won, too. Calgary's always strong, and Alberta you always expect to be up there. So it'll be interesting to see.
Yeah, I can't wait to see how everything shakes down. And We'll take a look at some of those numbers. But Coach Eve, I got to ask you about your coaching career. Now, you have stepped away from Langara. What are your thoughts? How are you feeling about your year off right now? How much can you tell us about what's permanent and where everything's going right now?
Well, you know, it's been interesting. I'm glad I did it because I just needed a break. So it's nice to, you know, get home from my real job, right? Working in West Vancouver School
exactly.
District at like 5:30 and not having to quickly eat something and run off to coach. So, no, it's been nice. I mean, I'm pretty sure I'll come back next year,
yeah.
But I'm just going to focus on working with the high school team at West Van this year.
Yeah, way to go, Eve. We love you. You're just a treasure. West Vancouver, the Highlanders, senior varsity, this team coach. The guys with the shorts and the historic plaid.
And by the way, I'm shopping, and it's so hard to find. Clothes is hard for a guy with a body like me to find anyway, but I want a plaid blazer, and I'm looking.
Oh.
So if there's anybody out there that has a large, like, triple XL plaid blazer, hit me up, because I want one.
Coach E puts the call out. I want to see that. Oh, my gosh, that'd be awesome. Great tradition at West Vancouver as we get set to enter our fourth quarter of play here from War Gym tonight. 56-52. UBC trailing, but with the basketball. Here's James Woods, drives on Penny, leans in and gets it to go off the glass.
Yeah, right at the end of the shot clock there. Great decision by Woods.
Shot out of a cannon, maybe the most dynamic hoop we've seen from James Woods, number 11. He came in averaging 20 points a game. Simon Fraser did a great job defensively. Three-pointer hoisted there. Right down the floor, and a great job there from Jack Cruz Dumont.
Yeah, back-to-back layups to tie it up.
Simon Fraser now with Beckett. Here they go to Penny. Game locked at 56. UBC showing some great spirit here to start the fourth quarter. Penny into the land of giants, has Sukman Sandu on him, drives and kicks out. Zaborniak, that one's good if it goes, and it doesn't from three. And apologies if I'm not getting number five from Simon Fraser's name wrong. Wilson Wong, the sports information director, will let me know if I'm getting it wrong here, but it's Oladele, number five, and I've been mentioning his name. The young man's been having a great game, so we'll try and get that right. Oladele. Here's Sandu, baseline, Sukman showing some dexterity. Oh,
that's got to be a foul. Yeah, it is. A bit of a late call, but that's a foul on Zaborniak, 100%.
So the big man takes a fall on the pine here at War Gym. Zaborniak with his second foul of the game. Jamal Wright, Elliott, Tamaki Langan into the game. Uladele coming
freshman
out.
Freshman going out.
So the former Tamanos Wildcat, who arrived at UBC via time at Fraser Valley, makes the first free throw. UBC taking the 1 point lead here. Sandu makes them both after going one of three earlier from the line. Of course, he came in with a sterling 86% free throw percentage in the preseason. Here's Demacki Langan, quickly to Penny. Lob inside to Wright. Jamal Wright, Wallaxonomy kicks back out to Beckett. Beckett using the physicality underneath to Demacki Langan. And well, that was a tangled mess of bodies on the baseline underneath the basket.
And once again, on that drive, he looked for the backdoor cut. And that's what he found. Did you see it? Here he goes here. He spins. Got boom, right there, backdoor.
There we
and
go.
Then Sukman comes over for the foul. But the zone continuing to give SFU difficulty. They are now 4 for 19 from the three-point line.
Wow.
Now, they're not calling that a shooting foul. I guess the referees are talking about it now. Sure looked like a shooting foul to me.
Instead, it'll be Demacki Langan inbounding from the baseline. 7:34 left.
Hansen trying to understand why it's not a shooting foul. And I don't blame him.
Lefebvre keeps his balance. They wanted a travel called there. Ooh, Demacki Langan blew a tire there. Cruz Dumont down to Woods. James, oh, and it's batted away.
It's going to be goaltending.
Beckett.
Whoa. Now the shot clock went off because it didn't get reset. How is that not goaltending?
Beckett got up and he's maybe thanking the basketball gods a bit.
I'd love to see that again. That had to be goaltending. Yeah, I think that's on the way down. Don't you? No?
I thought that was close. I don't know, Eve.
You might be right. I already announced it was goaltending, so I feel I have to defend my position. But after looking at it.
You could be right, but Beckett made a heck of an effort there.
It was close. Very close. And Steve Hansen still complaining about them not getting the call down to the other end. Kevin Hansen, irate right now, too. Look at him. Oh, my goodness. Things are picking up here, baby.
Yeah, and SFU athletic director Teresa Hansen looking on from the bench down here. So an interesting stretch drive we set ourselves up with. UBC with a two-point lead. Simon Fraser with the basketball. Here's Penny. Morense now on the floor. Beckett with a three ball. Not going to go. Sandu does a great job to shield off Jamal Wright. And Morense now back up the floor for UBC. Matthews thought about the quick strike and said to Sandu, deep three. Off the front iron into the hands of Penny. Right down the floor to Wright. Jamal right to the window. And Sandu there from behind.
Wow, he really came back and made a great block.
And Jamal Wright still down on the floor at the other end of the court as play continues. And he's slowly picking himself up. Here's Morense. Sandu toes the three.
That's a flop. What is he blowing his whistle for? Oh, my God. Okay, that I don't know what he was doing, but he's calling a flop on SFU, but he blew his whistle. You don't blow your whistle, right? Like, if you do a flop warning, you have to wait until the next stoppage in play. He blew his whistle on the shot, so he kind of panicked there.
Oh, okay, because
right,
I see that.
The shot went up from the corner, and he blew his whistle to give a flop warning. But you don't ever do that. You wait until the next stoppage in play before you give the flop warning.
Oh, you're right about that. We saw it on the replay, and clearly Sandu was wondering what was going on as
now,
he prepared to take the three.
How are they deciding who gets the ball? Because the ball was in the air when he blew the whistle. It should be a jump ball. But they're not going to. Let's see if they're going to a jump ball, because the arrow is pointing to UBC. But then the shot hit the rim, and there's eight on the shot clock. What are they doing? Man, they made a mess of this, honestly. They really have. I've never seen this before.
Well, they're going to go with eight on the shot clock, 6:30 remaining. UBC needs a quick release here. Tristan Matthews unable to get it to the basket. Sandu and Radichai was in there.
Oh, both coaches are very heated right now at things that are going on. And honestly, that was just really handled, not very well.
Not very well.
I'd love to find out after, talk to one of the referees, buddies of mine, to see what they did there. I've never seen that before, to be honest with you.
Well, Sandu's going to go to the free throw line. He's got a chance to give UBC a four-point lead if he can make this second free throw.
Yeah, and it would be, if he makes the second one, it'd be an 8-0 run for them to start this quarter. Right? It was 56-52, I believe.
I think you're right. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So UBC finding the spark when it needs it. Sandu back in a groove from the stripe. So 60-56, and SFU now needing a fire starter. Red Leafs with the basketball. Beckett muscles his way into the paint, draws the contact. Eric Beckett bringing a physicality to Simon Fraser, using the frame and. So Beckett will get to the free throw line here. This game really slowing down here in the fourth quarter.
But I agree with you, Howard. I like what Beckett's bringing the Red Leafs here. He's physical. Yeah. He's got a nice touch. He seems to be able to put it on the floor and handle the ball okay. I think he brings them a nice little bit of present for them from Vermont.
I know. And you know what? That was a flop, as you say. But you know what? He's getting in there.
Oh,
he's doing what he needs to do.
Yeah.
Try and win. He's a super competitive guy. Number 10, a transfer from Vermont, a Montreal native. Well, actually, Ajax, Ontario native. George Lefebvre from Vermont, the Montreal native. Those two Vermont players. Here's Woods now across to Wallach. Bryan finding James again. Double team comes quickly. Woods gets his way out of trouble, finds the big man. Sandu back to Woods, 8 on the shot clock. James now at the front, Radichai guarding him. Woods pulling up, gets the shot partially blocked. Wallach picks up the garbage, can't get it to go. Tristan Matthews, though, gets it right back. UBC will maintain possession, shot clock down to 9. Woods deep for 3. Ooh,
the place would have exploded if that had gone down.
A shot James Woods has made a number of times here as Morin Say crashes into the side trying to save the ball. 60-58, this is what it's all about. Lower Mainland basketball crosstown clash here at War Gym.
UBC's back in man-to-man now.
And Penny will shoot the 3. Off the window, he banks it home.
That always hurts when someone does that if you're...
Penny with a huge shot puts Simon Fraser on top by 1. Here's Cruz Dumont across the wall. Like Bryan gets Beckett in the air and drives to the basket. So Penny got called for the foul. UBC with the basketball. Cruz Dumont now. Catch and shoot. Tristan Matthews for 3.
Nice, confident looking shot there.
Sat out 19-20 on a red shirt. Sat out 2021 because of the COVID cancellation. Long time coming for Tristan Matthews to work his way into the lineup of this UBC Thunderbird rotation. Beckett is going to turn it over right in front of the UBC bench.
And yeah, he lost his footing there, and the ball went right out of bounds.
The blue and gold let him hear about it as they take over now. No team able to put a big run, although UBC, as Eve mentioned, did start this fourth quarter with a big enough run to arrest control back, and right now they maintain the 2-point lead. Cruz Dumont. Wallach drives on Radichai right to the window. Bryan Wallach showing dimensions in his game. He scores a big basket there. 65-61. Here's Jamal right back up top to Lefebvre. Penny, shot clock down to 6. Hoyce can't get it to go. What a great tip there by Jamal right underneath. He can't finish it. But look at the motor underneath, and he hits the deck hard.
Good offensive rebounding there by Simon Fraser, and Sandu's going to pick up a foul. He didn't box out.
So Sukman Sandu, you're right, he gets the foul as Jamal Wright gets to the free throw line. Jamal wasn't taking no for an answer and continued to chase that loose ball off the offensive glass, and he's rewarded with these trips here. Boy, he's got to take a deep breath. Recalibrates, number 15, makes it a 4-point game, or a 3-point game rather, 65-62. UBC with a lead in the basketball. Jack Cruz Dumont, Wallach, been so pivotal. His drives when he lowers his shoulder into both Lefebvre. And looks like Lefebvre's going to get called for the foul. I believe that'll be his... Is that his 4th?
I believe so.
Oh, it was on Radichai,
which is his 4th.
So Radichai will take a seat.
SFU's got a... Wallach loves to rip hard and go left. SFU, when he gets the ball, the high post needs to sit on his left hand and make him go the other way.
Now that you say that, I can just see in my mind's eye all of those moves to his left here, bringing the physicality as he makes his way to the basket. Nice job.
All right, Coach Hansen, that would be Steve Hansen, going to take his first time out of the second half.
Well, it's a 5-point lead now for UBC. Simon Fraser battling hard, but UBC finding a way to get things done. James Woods certainly coming to life in the second half of this basketball game, but boy, Brian Wallach has really shown that he's going to be one of the cornerstones of this team this year.
Yeah, clearly he has. He has developed his game very nicely, and just getting that, like, getting that extra strength is enabling him to get to the hoop more and take the contact and still get the shot off. And he's a very good rebounder too, as we both know as well. So I think he'll play a very important piece for them. We'll see if Kevin. I just have a feeling he might come out in the zone here, just for one possession. Just, you know, because Steve called the timeout, he might want to just throw out his zone this one time. The zone was very effective. We'll see if he does that just to mix it up. A lot of coaches like to do that at timeouts. When I was coaching at McNair, the great Al Rose, who coached at Britannia Sutherland.
Yeah.
We were playing Britannia, and we went in a big run. We were quite a bit ahead, and we do the timeout, and he's talking to his team, and the buzzer goes, and he goes, by the way, that coach is pretty good, and he probably just changed his defense on you, so ignore everything I just said. And I'm just laughing so hard because that's what I had just done, so it was pretty funny.
Oh, I love it, Evia. Yeah, if you think about it, you don't need to think too long to find a perfect example for everything that happens in this game.
Very true.
Beautiful. Here's DeMacky Langan coming out of that timeout. A rangy one, number 20. Here he is to Beckett. Jumps up. That's a tough shot to try and hit. He draws the contact. Both he and Tristan Matthews crash to the floor here at War.
Yeah, Matthews actually did a good job of challenging the shot, but he lost his balance and fell into him. You'll see here on the replay, and just gave him a little bump right at the end.
That's going to send Beckett to the free throw line. They're going to just take care of a wet spot on the floor here.
I mean, SFU hasn't made up for the free throw discrepancy completely, but they've cut into it quite a bit in the second half.
SFU's three returning players from last season, the backcourt of Penny and DeMacky Langan, along with Jamal White in the front court, and as well, the two Vermont transfers, Beckett and Lefebvre, they make up the five on the floor right now for head coach Steve Hansen.
And I'd be surprised if we saw any more subs out of SFU unless Radichai comes back in.
They got great performances from the freshmen tonight, but it's the veterans that are going to take it home for both of these teams. And we are veteran laden on the floor now with 3:34 remaining. Jack Cruz Dumont, Tristan Matthews, catch and shoot. Too strong off the back iron and right into the hands of Jamal Wright. Quickly now to DeMacky Langan. Penny will come and take it home as he crosses half court. David Penny pivots back up top to DeMacky Langan. Tries to beat Cruz Dumont. The kick, Lefebvre will take out the jump shot right over the goal into the hands of Cruz Dumont. Here's Wallach back out to Jack. Cross court to Sookman. And now it's Woods. He will eye the basket with 10 on the shot clock. James, the drive, the dish back up. Jack Cruz Dumont for three. Doesn't go. The tip is right there by Tristan Matthews. Big basket for the Birds. 2:39 remaining. 69-64 for the home team. Red Leafs now with the basketball. Lefebvre sets the pick on Woods, gets it back from DeMacky Langan, and he lays it up and in.
A little old school pick and roll there. Weak side from UBC didn't get there in time to help out.
So a big basket there from Lefebvre, who's been battling foul problems all night. Number 34, and he is huge in SFU's future this season. Getting close to 2 minutes remaining in the Granddaddy basketball game. Across town clashes here in the lower mainland. There's a turnaround hook that doesn't go. Gazina battling, or rather Wallach battling hard underneath.
Yeah, Sookman took a pretty bad shot there, but once again, UBC's presence on the offensive boards, and there was a foul, and now they're in the penalty. That's the fifth team foul, so UBC shooting the rest of the way.
That is going to send Wallach to the free throw line. Jack Cruz Dumont chatting with his teammate here after the miss on the first. make it a two-possession game here. Can't wrap it home. Tristan Matthews, though, active body, tips it off the back glass.
Oh, Steve Hansen not happy. That's three consecutive possessions with an offensive board.
Wow, look at that. Woods loses balance. Lefebvre right down the floor, and he lays it down. Big dunk from Lefebvre off the steal.
Ooh, baby, we got a game.
Woo, Simon Fraser to within one. 1:48 remaining. Here's Wallach. Drives into Beckett. Beckett takes the charge.
Yeah, Wallach not happy, but he did drop his shoulder on that. Let's take a look here. He drops his shoulder a bit, and I think that's why he got the call against him. Yeah, that's a good call. Chest to chest.
And you see number 10, he's going to be a favorite of Red Leafs fans back at the West Gym atop Burnaby Mountain when the GNAC starts play. Beckett, a guy who brings his emotions and his physicality to the court. So Simon Fraser, with 1:40 left, trailing by one, will get the basketball as Jamal Wright set the rebound on the baseline. He's got the veteran David Penny. He's got Tamaki Langan, number 20, Lefebvre, number 34, and number 10, Beckett. Simon Fraser's most veteran lineup on the floor right now. Here's Beckett. Oh, slips, recovers. Great job by Jack Cruz Dumont. Jack, right to the window, lays it up and in. Jack Cruz Dumont.
And it looks like SFU's going to take a timeout here. And they better get that wet spot up because you can see Beckett's asking them right now, can we get that wet spot up? Because he definitely slipped on a wet spot there, as you see right there.
And really threw that possession in the half court off balance. But full credit to number 10 wearing the blue and gold and white today, Jack Cruz Dumont. He gets that basketball, drives right down the court, lays it up and in. A tough basket under duress. 71-68.
Of course, as we're almost into November, so I mean, we obviously have all of our PacWest, U Sport, NCAA going. High school is going to be starting pretty soon too. Practices are starting already, and last weekend in November is the first time we're starting games. Of course, we have the HPT at the LEC.
It's going to be a great tournament 2 weeks in a row, Eve. I'm telling you, our boys' tournament literally.
Great draw.
It's a great draw. And the girls' draw that will follow, just outstanding. So, yeah, the TBI at the LEC.
I said HPT. What am I doing? I got those initials all mixed up.
Hey, we're got our minds on a great basketball game right in front of our eyes here. And we have had fun bringing you this. We'll bring it home for you. 1:27 remaining. What a game. Simon Fraser set the inbound in the front court. They are trailing by three. There's a handoff to Mackie Langan working off the Lefebvre screen. Elliott for three, and he is going to get fouled by Sufman Sandu.
Wow. Gutsy call.
Kerry Rokosh,
I don't
want to
lip read what Kevin Hansen. I don't want to lip read what Kevin Hansen just said, but wow. Okay. Well, three shots to tie the game here.
Elliott to Mackie Langan.
Will he tie it?
Yes, sir. Like clockwork, Eve, you're right. He was smooth from the free throw line. No jitters in number 20 as he takes a seat on the bench. Oladele coming in now, number 5, the freshman.
All right, let's see what UBC's going to run here.
All tied up at 71, 1:13 remaining. Quick three, Sukman. Sandu nails the triple.
Oh, baby. Off that curl screen again. He popped out after he set the curl screen for Woods.
It's a huge three by the big man from Tomatowa's secondary. Here's Lefebvre underneath, powering his way in. George Lefebvre with a big basket there, makes it a one-point game. We're under a minute remaining. Jack Cruz Dumont back for UBC. Tristan Matthews, big take into the paint. He can't get the roll, batted away underneath the basket.
And the T-Birds get it back.
Yes, you're right. I think Beckett number 10 is Simon Frazier.
And they get
it away.
They get 14 on the shot clock now.
Huge, huge for both teams here. Huge offensive possession, huge defensive possession. Here we go. Off the inbounds, Matthews, Sandhu in the paint. Sukman can't get it to go. Ripped out of the sky by Beckett.
He's double teamed.
And he gets it away to Penny. And SFU with a chance to take the lead. Penny driving, he's blocked underneath by Cruz Dumont. Lefebvre still with the basketball.
Oh, three in the key.
Three in the key.
Yeah. Just didn't get it up in time.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
So I think if I saw correct, I think it's 26 seconds left, I believe. 26.9, I think. So Kevin Hansen will get the choice here of whether to bring it to the front court or take it under his hoop. But if he brings it to the front court, the shot clock goes to 14. So he's going to take it under his hoop to force SFU to have to play defense.
Yep.
And now, will they foul? I think with only a 2.9 second difference, I almost think you have to foul or try to get a steal. I don't think you can let UBC wind it down that far. So we'll see if SFU comes with maybe a little full court pressure here.
Whew. It's come down to this.
Yeah, what a awesome game for
what a great game.
The over 2,000 fans that are here tonight, eh?
Yeah, and you know what? This is so great for our basketball community.
Ah, it's amazing.
Yeah, I mean, to every high school kid watching this stream, I mean, hey, this is what it's all about.
Absolutely.
And don't let anybody tell you anything else. This is an unbelievable atmosphere in this gymnasium tonight.
Now, this is very interesting. Oh, no, yeah, they are. No, it should be in. Oh, I guess. So the basket went in after the 3 second. So when you score, it goes on the sideline. But it's still backcourt,
back
so 24 seconds. Yeah.
So Lizdek will inbound the basketball. 2.9 second difference in the clocks here. Goes on the sidelines. Finds Woods. James Woods stutter step. Dribble to the basket. Gets it to go. James
time
Woods
out,
with a huge
out,
basket.
Time out. So that's that's very interesting because, I mean, obviously they had an opportunity for essentially a layup as James does a little nice crossover dribble there. But that does give SFU a chance to call the timeout, advance the ball, and they don't even have to take the three because there's enough time on the clock, they could get a quick two and foul. So sometimes in that situation, you'll see players dribble all the way through and come back out again to take more time off the clock.
Yeah, that was
so
interesting.
It's an interesting decision, right?
We'll see what happens, but James Woods has played himself into a major player now in this contest. 10 points, Wallach with 14 leading the Birds, as well Guzina with 10.
And you know what, if I'm SFU here, I mean, they're like 5 for 23 or something from the three-point line. I think with 21 seconds,
you take it
UBC,
inside.
They're really going to guard the three, right? So you can probably get a quick two, and then you want to try to foul one of the UBC players that you hope will miss a free throw. But it's still going to be a one-possession game either way. No teams. SFU's last timeout, too. They got none left.
What a finish we're in store for here. UBC with one timeout remaining. Simon Frazier without a timeout here. 21.1 SFU in the front court. Elliot Tamaki Langan will inbound the basketball. 7 second difference on the clocks here. Radichai gets the basketball, guarded, double team, tries to make a reverse go, can't get it to go. Cruz Dumont is fouled immediately.
And that's an unsportsmanlike foul. So that's huge, because that's going to be two in the ball. After he missed the free throw, he grabbed him. You'll see right
from
here,
behind,
right? He misses
behind.
A little layup. And then as the player's going away, he just reaches out and grabs the shirt. Personally, I would not call that an unsportsmanlike, just because I hate it. But I understand why they have to call it, because he grabbed the jersey. You know, from a fan point of view, you want to keep it a bit more interesting, right? And I just think it's a soft call, but that is the FIBA rules, so correct call was made there.
Oh, and he missed the free throw. Would have made it a two-possession game, so all the impetus on this one here by Cruz Dumont. And he makes the second. So it's a four-point UBC lead. They're going to get the basketball back.
So now, SFU, you got a foul right away without grabbing a jersey. They can't afford another unsportsmanlike foul.
Well, whoever wins this game, it's a battle of survival. And Wallach will inbound the ball. Lefebvre set to guard him on the inbounds pass in the front court. UBC right now in the driver's seat. We'll see what happens. Basketball's a funny game. 13.7 shot clock off. Wallach finding Woods, and he's fouled immediately there by Elliot Demaculanga. Twelve and a half seconds left in James Woods. Had 4 points at the half, has had 6 points in the second half in a very low scoring game here tonight. Woods is going to make the first.
Well, now whether he makes or misses this next one, SFU has to shoot a three this possession. They got no choice. And they got to get it up within five seconds.
A tall order for the Red Leafs. Here's Woods, and he sinks the second. It's a six-point game, 12 and a half seconds left.
Smart move here. UBC putting a little pressure on, force SFU to take a bit of time off the clock. Probably just soft pressure.
It'll be yep. David Penny set to inbound the basketball. Critical juncture here. Simon needs a quick three. Here they go to Lefebvre, right back to Penny. He's going to hoist. No, he's going to drive right into the paint. Can't get that to go. Matthews with a rebound.
Yeah,
down to 5 seconds.
That's going to do it.
That's going to do it. The UBC Thunderbirds are going to win the Buchanan Cup. They have done it. 79-73. They have reclaimed the golden orb of crosstown basketball supremacy. They win it by six. And it really was a game of survival here. And UBC with the victory. Eve to the victor. The spoils. The 2022 Buchanan Cup.
Yeah, no, they lost it last year at SFU. They regained it back at home. And, like we talked about last year, this year just solidifies. This rivalry is back and bigger than ever. I'm sure next year we'll even top this, because it was a great game. A bit sloppy at times, but it's so early, right?
It's so early.
But came right down to the very end, so you can't ask for much more than that.
You certainly can't. The emotion that this game is played at is what makes it special, and it's why we love this game here in the province of British Columbia. UBC with a 79-73 victory to win the Buchanan Cup. We'll let the images sink in here as we get to the end of our broadcast. Give it a couple more minutes as the Thunderbird players gather at center court.
By the way, there was a good amount of SFU fans here tonight, too.
Behind you, you see a lot of red. Certainly was. Yeah. They traveled well, and that's good for the health of the series. UBC with a six-point victory. Thunderbirds now waving to their fans. Simon Fraser doing the same, because they've got their own. They've got their own fans, and the Thunderbirds here coming over to our broadcast location as well. Sukhman Sandhu, what a great job he did. They love you, Ebe. A great job by all concerned, and I don't know what more you can say about a great effort as Cavi Tour now set to present the Buchanan Cup.
Well, and you know that I don't think Coach Steve, I mean, Steve Hansen's competitive and he's not going to be happy to lose ever, but I think when he reflects back and sees how well they played for where they are,
yeah, you're right.
I think he'll be pretty happy.
Yeah. Simon Fraser, we mentioned off the top, their theme, three returning guys this year that played any minutes at all, and the rest of the group either promoted to bigger roles or coming in as first-time SFU Red Leafs, and they've really come together. And there is Brian Wallach, the man of the moment, number 7. He hoists the Buchanan Cup. And a great job by number 7, who was pivotal in the victory tonight.
Well, you know, last year we talked about how it'd be interesting when Kevin returned home. Now it's the other way. Now Teresa's had to take the loss this year.
Yeah, there'll be some interesting conversations there.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Very interesting to see UBC players right now getting very excited. They have played two big games here. They fill this place for UNLV. They fill it today for SFU.
Yeah.
It's a great catapult for them into their Canada West
season.
Well,
also, too, just even like the fact that they're now 7-0, but, they, I mean, they beat Brock, who's going to be a top-10 team, Calgary, who's likely going to be a top-10 team, and Regina, who's going to be one of the better teams in the Canada West. So they've had some nice wins early.
They certainly have. The UBC Thunderbirds, they are celebrating after finding a way to claim victory in the golden bauble that is the Buchanan Cup. They pose for a team picture here at center court. I think what we're going to do is we're going to sign off. We're going to let the pictures speak for themselves here from this historic venue in Vancouver. And we'll see how long the feed goes on for, but I want to thank Paul Eberhardt for joining me. Paul will be joining me on, joining me on some SFU broadcasts this year,
hey,
too. That'll be fun.
I got a bit more freedom, you know, so I can definitely do some of those games. Yeah,
it's going to be fun, and of course, we're always going to be together for high school stuff. It's going to be fun to see. But thank you for everyone for watching, for joining us, and seeing what basketball is all about in the Lower Mainland here in British Columbia. For Paul Eberhardt, for Troyelle Brown, and the entire production crew here at War Gym, Howard Samura, a bit you farewell from War Memorial Gymnasium.
Woo!